Equations of motion. We have learned that initial velocity of a moving object is represented by u, its final velocity is represented by v, the time taken in changing the speed is represented by t, acceleration is represented by a, and distance traveled we represent it by s. Now if you relate these quantities u, v, t, a and s, you get these three equations which are called equations of motion. First equation of motion is v equal to u plus a t. Then second equation of motion is s equal to ut plus half a t square. Third equation is v square minus u square is equal to 2as. You are not going to change the sequence. Like this is first equation, it will remain this only. Second equation this, and third equation this. We start the derivation of equations of motion starting with the first equation, v is equal to u plus a t. This is the graph. First understand the graph. We have considered that there is an object which has started from point A, that is A is the initial point, and it reaches to point B. So this AB is the main graph showing the motion of the object. In the previous graphs we took it generally from origin, but here since initial velocity we have taken non-zero, so we assume that the object starts from A and reaches B. At point A, its initial velocity is u, and at point B, its final velocity is v. So, in the graph, this length of OA, the distance between origin and A, will be initial velocity u. And same here, the distance between this final point B and the distance x-axis, it is BC, which is equal to the final velocity v. Now, we have drawn these dotted lines. These dotted lines are drawn by us. Like this AD, it is drawn parallel to OC. Similarly, this BC is drawn perpendicular, this BE is also drawn perpendicular. We will be using them in solving the equations. Now, if you look at the graph, this AD and this OC, because this angle is 90 degrees, so AD and OC will be parallel lines, and also it will become a rectangle. This OADC will become a rectangle. So the length of opposite sides of a rectangle is equal, we know that. So this OC and this AD, the length of these two will be equal. So if this OC is equal to T, this AD will also be equal to T, where T is the time taken by the object to reach from A to B. Now understand from the graph, if you look at this length BD, you can find it by subtracting this BC. If you subtract CD from this entire length BC, I repeat it again, if you subtract this length CD or DC from this length BC, you will get BD. So this is what I have written here, BD equal to BC minus CD, this. But since it's a rectangle, CD will be equal to OA. So CD is replaced by OA in the next line. I have replaced CD by OA. So if you calculate the value of BC, it will be BD plus OA. BC, we know it is V. So V, and OA, U. So I have substituted the values and I have calculated the value of BD, which comes V minus U. Now we know the formula of acceleration. It is change in velocity upon time taken. We know this formula. So if you apply this formula, A equal to change in velocity. Initial change in velocity means final velocity minus initial velocity. Now this BC is representing the final velocity, so BC. Initial velocity OA is representing the initial velocity, so BC minus OA upon T. Now we have already done that BC minus OA, it is equal to BD. So we have substituted this value BD here. So A becomes BD upon T. But the value of BD we have also calculated. It is V minus U upon T. Now you all know the cross multiplication. When you do the cross multiplication, it becomes V minus U equal to A into T. This is AT. When you take this U to the right hand side, it becomes V equal to U plus AT. So this is the derivation of first equation of motion. This is first equation of motion. V equal to second equation of motion, S equal to ut plus half a t square. In this equation, S represents the distance traveled by the object, the distance traveled by the body. Like if you consider this graph, the object is going from A to B. So the distance covered is given by, this we have learned previously, the distance covered in a VT graph is calculated by the area which is lying under AB, the area which is lying under the graph. So AB is the graph. So this area, which is lying under AB, will be equal to the distance covered by the object. Now, if you look at this OABC, it's a trapezium. Since these sides are parallel sides and these are non-parallel sides. Now, this OABC is a trapezium. So we have written distance is equal to area of trapezium OABC. If you look at this figure carefully, you can divide this trapezium into a triangle and a rectangle. So this is what I have done. I have divided it into two figures, two different figures. A, triangle ADB, and this rectangle ADCO. Now, area of triangle, we know the formula. It's a right angle triangle since this angle is 90 degree. Area of a triangle is half base height. And area of a rectangle is length into breadth. So we have applied this formula, half AD into BD plus half OA into OC. Now from the graph, this we have done previously also. From the graph, this OA we know is equal to U. This OC and AD, they are equal, is equal to T. And the length of BD, previously we have calculated, it is equal to V minus U. Now we will be using first equation of motion in this. BD we know is equal to V minus U. Now from the first equation of motion, we also know that the value of V is U plus A into T. Substitute this value here. In place of V, put U plus AT. And minus U is already there. So this U and this U will be cancelled. So the value of BD will be equal to A into T. If you substitute all these values, the values of AD, BD, OA, OC into this equation, you will get the value of S, which is S equal to half this T into AT plus U into T. So this T into T becomes T square. So half A I have written here, A T square plus U into T is UT. So this equation becomes S equal to half AT square plus UT, or you can write it like this, S equal to UT plus half AT square. So this is the derivation of second equation of motion. Third equation of motion, V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. Now we will be using the same method as we did for the second equation, that is distance is equal to area of this trapezium OABC. Now S equal to, we know the formula of area of trapezium is half sum of parallel sides into height. Now if you look at this figure, these are the parallel sides OA and BC. So these are the parallel sides, so this S becomes half OA plus BC into height, this OC, since this angle is 90 degree, it becomes height OC. Now from the graph, we know these values already, OA is equal to U, BC equal to V, and this OC equal to T. If you substitute all these values into this equation, you will get S equal to half U plus V into T. Now if you look at this equation carefully, V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. You will observe that there is no T in this equation. This equation, the time taken is not there in this equation. So what we have to do is, we have to eliminate this T. This T we have to eliminate. So for this we will use the first equation, V equal to U plus AT. The first equation we already know this equation. So we will use this equation, V equal to U plus AT. If you bring this U side, left hand side, it becomes negative. So V minus U equal to A into T, and this A is in multiplication, it will go in division. So the value of T comes V minus U upon A. Now, since we have to eliminate T from this equation, we will substitute this value of T into this equation. The value which you have obtained from equation 1, you will substitute here. So this equation, this S now becomes S equal to half U plus V into this V minus U upon A, V minus U upon A. Now 2 into A will become 2A, and this U plus V, you can also write it like V plus U, and this is V minus U. Now we will apply the formula of A plus B, A minus B, which is A square minus B square. So it will become V square minus U square. Into 1 means same thing, V square minus U square. Now again do this cross multiplication. This 2A into S will become 2AS, and 1 into V square minus U square will become V square minus U square. So this is the third equation of motion.